Hi everyone, this is Sudhir, working as Associate Professor at Department of Pharmacology, Raghavendra Institute of Pharmaceutical Education Research Autonomous, Anantapuram, AP. So these are the students of 4th year B Pharmacy. As a part of their curriculum activity, they need to do project work. So as a part, we are doing project work on anti-urolithic activity of some medicinal plants. What is urolithiasis? Urolithiasis is nothing but formation of stones in the kidney. So majorly these stones are found because of excessive accumulation of calcium oxalate salts. The main way to treat these renal stones is only one is invasive procedure by which you can remove the stones from the kidney. Still, it has some complications. So even though it is a only one better option, but it has some complications and as well as it imposes a high cost and patience. So many of the populations, looking for better alternative for invasive procedure. Here, since ancient times, you are using medicinal plants for number of various disease or disorders. So you are taking that lead for development of anti-urolithic activity. So by taking that lead, you are planning to investigate anti-urolithic activity of some Ayurvedic medicinal plants. In this, we are assessing anti-urolithic activity of medicinal plants by using three in vitro assays. This is in vitro assays. The name of in vitro assays are, one is nucleation assay, aggregation assay, oxalate, calcium oxalate depletion assay. So these students can explain each procedure.
I am J.J. Eshwini, 4th B Pharmacy, Raipur. We are doing project on anti-urolithic activity by using some medicinal plants. These are our project mates. He is Veeresh, she is Rajeshwari, he is Upendra. Based on literature review, we have collected 5 different medicinal plants. The medicinal plants we collected in and our surroundings of our campus. The medicinal plants are washed, dried under shade. After drying, we powdered the plants. The powder is kept for succulation, that is for extraction. The succulation is done by using methanol as solvent. Succulation, the extract for concentration, we kept it for rotary evaporation. We got the concentrated product, that is semi-solid consistency product. We got all the different 5 different plant materials like this. This is our product. This product, now we prepared the stock solution. Stock solution means equal concentration in equal ml. We prepare stock solution of 1 mg in 1 ml. That stock solution, again we prepare dilutions of different concentrations like 1000 microgram per ml, 100 microgram per ml, 200 microgram per ml. From the concentrated product, we prepare stock solution. Stock solution means equal concentration in equal ml. We prepare 1 mg in 1 ml stock solution. From the stock solution, we again diluted the solution. The diluted solutions are 100 microgram per ml, 200 microgram per ml, 400 microgram per ml, 800 microgram per ml, 1000 microgram per ml. These dilutions we done for every plant material. According to literature review, we had done in vitro studies by using 3 different assays. The first assay is nucleation assay, the second one is aggregation assay, and the third one is oxalate depletion assay. Now I am explaining about the nucleation assay. The chemicals required for nucleation assay are Crisp buffer, sodium chloride, calcium chloride, sodium oxalate and the extracts. For maintaining the pH, divide the crisp buffer into two equal halves. In each equal half, in first half we have to add calcium chloride, in second half we have to add sodium oxalate. Now we have to add some quantity of sodium oxalate solution and some quantity of calcium chloride solution and kept aside for 30 minutes for the formation of crystals, that is calcium oxalate crystals. Of the formation of crystals, we have to add 1 ml of extract solution of each concentration separately. After addition of extract, again kept aside for 30 minutes. After that, we have to calculate percentage inhibition by knowing the optical densities of different concentrations using UV instrumentations. The next aggregation assay is explained by our project mate Rajeshwari.
Hello friends, I am Rajeshwari from 4th BFarm. As Teju said, I am going to explain about aggregation assay. In aggregation assay, I am going to explain about the procedure, how we have to do this procedure. We have to take this buffer and we have to add CaCl2 and sodium oxalate of few mg and we have to keep it aside for overnight for the formation of crystals. As we can see over here, by keeping overnight we can see the crystal formation. Now take few ml of this solution into different test tubes, add 1 ml extract of different concentration of different medicinal plants. By that we can keep aside for 30 minutes and we can observe the absorbance using UV instrumentation. By that we can calculate the percentage inhibition of calcium oxalate crystals. Next, oxalate depletion assay will be explained by Veerish.
I am Veerish. As Adi said, I am explaining about calcium oxalate depletion assay. For this we have to prepare calcium oxalate slurry. We have maintained pH 5.7. For this we have added sodium acetate. For this we have to keep aside. After that we have prepared this buffer. For this we have to add calcium chloride and sodium oxalate. This solution we have to add extract for some ml. After that, kept in 10 minutes aside. We have to observe even. After that, kept aside for 10 minutes. We have to go for UV instrumentation for observance to check optical density. We check percentage inhibition.
Now we are going to enter into sophisticated instrumentation lab near UV to check optical density. Now we are near UV visible double beam spectrophotometer. Now we have to calculate the optical density for different concentrations. We are here to observe the optical density of different concentrations of different extracts. We are here taking methanol as a plant and we are keeping wavelength at 620 nanometers and we are taking control here. All the chemicals are added except the extract.
In this cuvette we have placed methanol as the blank and we are placing the sample over here. So now let us run the UV. Let's start the UV. Then we have to okay this. Then we can observe the absorbance over here. We have to note all these absorbance. Then we can calculate the percentage inhibition.
By using this formula for percentage inhibition, we can calculate the percentage inhibition of 5 different medicinal plants. By substituting optical density of all the different concentration of different medicinal plants, we have to substitute over here and we have to substitute the optical density of control over here. By this we can calculate the percentage inhibition of different plant materials. By calculating all the inhibition values, we came to know that among all the 5 medicinal plants, we have selected only 3 that are having best percentage inhibition values. So we are going further for preclinical trials using these 3 medicinal plants. Thank you.
Hello friends, my name is Tiyupendra. I am now going to conclude that based on the percentage inhibition of the 5 extractions, we have concluded that only 3 are the best So we have selected them for the preclinical trials. As we selected the medicinal plants, natural medicinal plants. So these are the very cost effective and they are easily available.